So when you want to communicate, there are few things which will make you create a successful communicator. I am not an expert in that, to teach you on the science behind it, that matter will take you. But some of my feelings on communication, any communication starts with basically the idea generation. The first thing to happen in your brain is the generation of an idea. If the idea is not there, how will you communicate? And once the idea is generated, the next thing what you need is the vocabulary. When I say vocabulary, don't try to relate it with English only. It is true in all the languages, English, it could be Hindi, it could be English, it could be French, German, Tamil, Malayalam, no problem. In whichever language you are communicating, you need to have a real knowledge or depth of knowledge or that pressure of capacity in English. Then you can really become a good communicator. A communication you can do in different ways. Basic communication purpose is to convey the idea or a message. But the same thing, if you communicate in a structured way, the influence what it can generate is much higher. That is why we talk about grammar. Why we need grammar in communicating is to show that how serious you are and how better effectively you can communicate. All the developed societies they could communicate well because they structured it in a scientific way, that is why the knowledge of grammar is also very important. We also talk about the rest and address, which I am always telling you whenever I meet you, when you go for campus placement, meeting people. Two things are very important, how you are going to dress up and how you are going to address. So dress and address are two important issues which you have to inculcate. You have to dress for the occasion. If I am going to a house, after hearing about my colleague's father's death, if I go for the same kind of dress, it will not work. That is not a dress for. But when I come to our head, when I address question that is right or clear. I have to present myself in the right way. So that is very important. And when you address also, how you are going to address it? I am not going deep into that. Only a few points I am trying to touch on. And the next point which will help you to therefore communicate would be your knowledge and ability in learning modulation in your communication. Modulation is very important. Where you need to raise your voice, where you need to reduce your voice, and where you need to be really polite, all these are very important. So modulation is only also very important. And another two important aspects of communication could be the pause and address for you. You need to pause it wherever you really need. There is a very famous saying, once was a culprit was sentenced to kill by a judge. And he sent a death warrant, it was a letter. Hang him, not kill him. You heard about it. Hang him, not kill him. So just because of the difference of a comma, where it is put, he would escape from the death. So where you are going to pause it, in any communication, that makes a big difference. And the gesture of an individual can be communicated. That can also convey a lot of how confident he is. Or how authoritative he is. To understand that you should know the famous speeches of all the world leaders, like you go and see how Obama speaks, or how Modi, how they use the gesture the right way. So that will also give you a lot of idea to be able to communicate. The first problem for any student or beginner when you start communicating is actually we don't know what to do with these 2 hands. These 2 hands are extra. When you go to the stage first time now, can you just listen to me?
Guys, please settle down.
Settle down.